We have Dominic with some places and things to do over the summer.
Thank you for the Dominic, for those great places. For our next package, this video, one class has created hype for class, and here are some of our favorites.
that was exciting.
Next up, we have a recipe on how to make a Kool-Aid slushie.
Hey guys, and today I'll show you guys how to make yourself a quick, simple slushie using these simple ingredients. You know, in Arizona, it tends to be really hot, so I just wanted to show you guys how to make a quick, simple slushie at home and have a cool drink. The ingredients that we're using today are 4 cups of ice, 1 packet of Kool-Aid, the flavor I chose was cherry, 1 cup of sugar, one cup and a half of cold water, and a blender.
So the first step you're going to do is pour the cold water into the blender. And the next step is pouring all the sugar. And after that, add in the Kool-Aid. Then you're going to pour in all the ice. Make sure you be careful when pouring the ice because I wasn't and made a mess. And then blend. Make sure you blend it good because you don't want any big chunks of ice in the drink. And there you go, you got yourself a cool, refreshing slushie.
Thank you, Nathan and Sam. I can't wait to try this out.
Up next, we have the final dance show of the year.
The second someone mentioned you were all alone, I could feel the trouble coursing through your veins. Now I know he's got a hold. Just a phone call left unanswered and we sparking now. These cigarettes won't stop me wondering where I'm gonna let go. Keep on hold. Cause if you look into the distance, there's a house upon the hill, guiding like a lighthouse. It's a place where you'll be safe to feel like Christ, cause we've all made mistakes. If you flash away, we'll have to leave it alone.
That was amazing. Truly talented students. Next up, we have an interview short film by some of our very own students.
This is Leslie Rodriguez.
What grade are you in?
I'm a sophomore.
Samuel Mian.
What grade are you in?
I am a junior. I
came up with the idea of for my film because one day I was in my room just listening to music, and I've always liked like old music, like 50s through 80s, and I happened to be listening to 50s music, and that just inspired me because I knew for a fact there that I wanted my film to be based like in the 50s, and I wanted some type of like funny like teenage romance movie because I had just finished watching the movie Flipped, and so I wanted my film to be kind of inspired like from Flip, so that's how I came up with the idea.
Feels good, but also kind of weird because the way I got into the short film, it was the director invited me to be in the shooting, and I didn't think much of it. And even the first time I didn't go because I was sick. That was obviously me due to being sick. But second time I went, I didn't expect to be this big. I just had fun with it, you know, so. But it does feel good.
To finish my film fully, it took me like about 3 months because it was like about a month for me to come up with the idea, and it took me like about 2 weeks to write my script and everything. And then to film, it took like about a month. So yeah, I'd say like about 3 months it took to fully finish my film.
I kind of feel embarrassed just because, you know, it's the big screen. But I don't know who's going to be at the movie theater with us. I haven't really dug into it that much, but yeah, embarrassing.
Yes, my little film crew. So for my actors that starred in it, it was Michaela Ruiz, Tony Fernandez, and Samuel Millen. Tony Fernandez was an actor / my cameraman. Samuel Millen was pretty much, I wouldn't say the star of my film, but like a pretty main character, like a main character in my film. And Michaela Ruiz was also one of the main characters, and of course there's me.
Being around my co-stars, I think they did their role pretty good. And honestly, it was just us hanging out most of the time. We just had fun on set. We would just mess around with each other. I remember the last time we recorded, we were just chilling at the director's house, just playing water guns or playing basketball. And it was cool. It was basically just us hanging out.
Having my short film being played at Harkins, this is my second year that it's played at Harkins, so I'm really excited. I'm hoping to get first place this year. Last year I got second place, so hopefully I get first place. And yeah, I'm just really excited to see my film play in the big screen, so yeah.
How do you feel? Good. What place did you get?
Third.
I'm just kidding, I got third.
Well done, keep up the great work, and we can't wait for the next one. Now we'll be having a commercial break.
Fentanyl is a drug, and even just a tiny amount is lethal.
I've heard that even a single grain of fentanyl can kill you.
Many people who have addictions to drugs may have accidentally ingested fentanyl that has been laced with it and have passed away from that.
Can be found in other drugs such as weed, or if we want to go higher, we could go and say cocaine, meth, literally anything.
Just don't do it. It's not worth the risk.
Go seek help and know that there are people out there that want to help them.
It's not good for your health. It's going to come back to you later in life.
To avoid winning a stupid prize, you should avoid playing stupid games.
Just one little pill can kill.
Like, you should just not be doing it.
Stop, because it's not worth the risk.
Stop taking drugs. You can get help and you will do better.
Well, Up next, we have teachers' advice for seniors that are going to college.
Some tips for seniors going into college. My advice to them is to be willing to do the boring work. You have to be willing to be consistent with doing the work you need to do, like the reading, showing up to class on time. And then that's honestly something that you'll do regardless. And then the other advice I would give is get afternoon classes. Get all your classes in the afternoon, because it's going to be a big adjustment. And you're going to have a lot going on, whether you're working, being an athlete. You definitely want to have a cushion of time in between.
All right, hi guys, I'm Ms. Patton, I'm D9 math. Some tips I have for my lovely seniors that I'm gonna miss so much as they go off to college is, one, always take care of yourself. Please remember to eat, sleep, drink water, wear sunscreen. Additionally, don't take 8 a.m. classes, don't do that to yourself. Make sure you take mid-afternoon or like evening classes.
My tip for seniors going into college is to be careful going to these parties, right? I'm not saying don't go to parties, like go ahead, have fun, but just be careful, right? Because, you know, there might be some products there that you shouldn't be taking. I remember in my senior year of high school, I wasn't friends with him, but I knew this guy. He got full ride scholarship to his college, right? He was set, right? Straight A student, and went to his party. I guess he got a little too excited, and he started drinking at that party, and he thought he was okay to drive home. And he tried, he got pulled over, got a DUI, lost his whole scholarship, couldn't go to that college, you know, and that DUI is on your record. So, you know, I just gotta say, be careful. Not saying that you can't go to parties and have fun, but, you know, be smart, be wise.
Tips for class of 23 going straight to college. I recommend you create a schedule for yourself. Do something every single day, but give yourself time off so that way you take care of yourself. And then I would definitely say make sure you get involved. If you're going to a big university, you need to go to those games and go to the parties, have fun. But, you know, it's college. Take it seriously. Don't waste any money.
Some tips I have for seniors going off to college would be to have the ability to network. I think networking is a big thing, especially nowadays. It's not what you know, it's who you know. So make sure you get around the right people. Make sure you get around people that are smarter than you. And make sure you get around people that have the same goals and interests that you do. Sometimes you can get caught up with the wrong people and it can take you off your course to where you're trying to go. And then another thing that I would say is make sure you manage your money correctly. Managing money is a big thing, especially in college. You're not going to have a lot of it. And learning how to have an ability to manage money when you don't have it will help you as you get older when you start to have money.
Thank you for those words of encouragement. We wish you the best of luck, seniors. Next up is a quick look on the art in the Sea Hall.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stark, for that look. Up next is found footage video by our fellow members.
Amid the various kidnappings in the Renton area, I was tasked with investigating their origins, though I'm pretty sure I already know what caused it. I found a few recordings, so I might as well share them. This is clip 1, taken on May 23rd, 2004, 10:07 p.m. in the Renton, Washington area. Not much happens here.
Sing on.
I mean, you clicked the button, didn't you?
Well, yeah, I'm not an idiot.
You sure about that?
Are you talking about the camera or my intellect?
A bit of both.
Well, I'm not an idiot for wanting to make sure this thing actually works.
And it is done. Look at this. Look at this dude.
Stop. This is serious.
Uh-huh. Well, I mean, if it's so serious, why don't we just, like, go to another?
Huh? Well, that's the first sensible thing you actually said.
Mm-hmm. All this talk of wanting to bring a camera and you left it behind.
The next clip was taken on May 23rd, 2004, 10:23 p.m. Again, not much happens.
See, I told you this was 100% serious.
This is so cool.
I wasn't messing around. You're not even listening to me, are you?
Uh-huh. This is just so cool. I can zoom in, like, all the way over there. Jeez.
You're just using this as an excuse to try out my camera.
Yep. Uh-huh.
Oh, my God. Anyways, what I was saying, you need to stop messing around and actually, like, focus here. This is serious. You just stop wasting the battery. Just...
And finally, we have clip 3, taken on May 23rd, 2004, 10:26 p.m. This is the most interesting of the bunch.
So, I tied it up last time I was here. Are you recording?
Yeah, I am.
Alrighty. So, this is the point of origin. This is where...
You sounded like it's something out of, like, a secret government tape or something.
I'm telling you, man, I saw something. It was, like, something straight out of Lovecraftian. It had, like, big claws and... I told you, man, there's something in there.
Okay, yeah, you got me. There's a mythical creature in there, yeah. Let's call it a raccoon, yeah. Wait, you're going in. You put your hood up and you're going in. Hey, I really don't want to go in here, you know? I like babies and all that. Like, I really don't. Wait, why are we whispering? No one else is, like, even here.
I don't want to scare the creature.
The raccoon?
What the?
Oh, I get it. You're playing a prank on me. You got someone else to join in?
No, what the? You know me better than that, dude.
Hand me the flashlight. What the? Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay. Well, that was an experience, right?
Capture him or kill him have failed, and without intervention, he will continue to feast upon the people nearby. An order is already underway to evacuate the surrounding area under guise of a gas leak. Honestly, they might even go through creating an actual explosion just to cover this all up. Anyways, that is all that I found on this topic, and I will continue to document findings and look for this wretched thing. Oh God.
Thank you, Stark, Derek, and Dylan, for that found footage.
This week, Nathaniel asked a few teachers what they think students should do over the summer.
I'm Nathaniel, and today I asked a few teachers what they think students should do over the summer.
Couple things. Read the First Amendment. Get off of social media. One more thing. Find a girl or a boy. Fill a cooler up with soda and water. Go to a lake. And go swimming for a whole day.
Oh, I definitely think students should relax, hang out with their friends, do their hobbies. You're only going to be a student for so long, once you're an adult, you don't have summers anymore, so make the most of it.
What they're probably going to do is sleep, but what they should do is maybe try a new hobby, do an activity that they've never done before, travel, or just read.
That was really some great advice. Thank you.
Next up is James Hart with Volleyball Senior Night.
Sage Badgett and senior.
LaBelle Harrington, senior.
Ooh, I love that rush, that energy, and that that family environment that we really bring to this sport.
The energy is different compared to other sports.
Sport taught me how to never stop trying. Don't give up.
I would say, like, if you don't get a point, people will still keep you uplifted. And if you get a point, everybody gets excited.
Favorite moment? Probably just hanging around new people every year and just getting to know brand new people.
I would say probably our first win. No. When we beat Independence, and it was when they came here, and we had more energy than compared when we were at their home.
That looks so fun. Cannot wait for that.
Make sure to follow our socials.
Thank you for watching, and we wish you a great day. DeTv out.